I understand that the students know what they're learning by just having a conversation with them. A lot of times we do turn and talks, and it's just my turn to listen to them and see if they're using that vocabulary or looking up there. The whole reason we have this in here is they have a place to look at. If we didn't have that in there, then a lot of them probably would be a little confused or maybe not know what we're learning. I mean, some of them would, but this definitely helps them to put their focus on what they're supposed to be learning. And then just listening and having the conversation. Doesn't have to be a lengthy conversation, just a quick, what are we learning today in math? What do we need to know in order to do that learning target? And then we move on and get to the content. What I have learned in doing the formative assessment and checking the learning target and success criteria is just realizing how the students are checking their understanding themselves. That's the biggest eye-opener for me, is that they can really check to see where they're at. Sometimes you do have those students who will just give you a thumbs up all the time, like, yeah, I got it, yeah, I got it, yeah, I got it. But we know as teachers, when we go to actually do the work and stuff, we can see what students do that, and we're gonna have students like that. But I do have students that will really check to see where they're at. They'll give me that thumbs in the middle, and they know that they don't count one-to-one correctly all the time, that's something that they work on, so they give me that thumbs in the middle. Or like in the lesson today, they give me a thumbs in the middle that they're not always so good at putting the two groups together to add. So just seeing how the students are self-reflecting on themselves and their own learning, and that's the whole idea of the learning targets and success criteria in the first place.